Wait, this next test does require some explanation. Let me give you the fast version. There, if you have any questions, just remember what I said in slow motion. Test on your own recognizance. I'll be right back. The aerial faithplate in here is sending a distress signal. You broke it, didn't you? There. Try it now.
What happened, right? I was just lying there. You thought I was done.
This plate must not be calibrated to someone of your generousness. I'll add a few zeros to the maximum weight. You look great, by the way. Very healthy. Try it now.
Couldn't believe it either.
You seem to have defeated its load-bearing capacity. Well done. I'll just lower the ceiling. Look at you, sailing through the air majestically, like an eagle, piloting a blimp. Enjoy this next test. I'm going to go to the surface. It's a beautiful day out. Yesterday I saw a deer. If you solve this next test, maybe I'll let you ride an elevator all the way up to the break room. And I'll tell you about the time I saw a deer again. the test. I didn't see the deer today. I did see some humans. But with you here, I've got more test subjects than I'll ever need. These bridges are made from natural light that I pump in from the surface. If you rubbed your cheek on one, it would be like standing outside with the sun shining on your face. It would also set your hair on fire, so don't actually do it. Excellent. You're a predator, and these tests are your prey. Speaking of which, I was researching sharks for an upcoming test. Do you know who else murders people who are only trying to help them? Did you guess sharks? Because that's wrong. The correct answer is nobody. Nobody but you is that pointlessly cruel. Good news. I figured out what to do with all the money I save recycling your one room full of air. When you die, I'm going to laminate your skeleton and pose you in the lobby. That way future generations can learn from you how not to have your unfortunate bone structure. Perfect. The door's malfunctioning. I guess somebody's going to have to repair that too. No, don't get up. I'll be right back. Don't touch anything.
Hey! Hey! Up here! I found some bird eggs up here. Just dropped me into the door mechanism. Shut it right down. Bird! 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 Okay. That's probably the bird in it that laid the eggs. Livid. Okay, look, the point is, we're going to break out of here, all right? Very soon, I promise. I just have to figure out how to break us out of here. Here she comes. Keep testing. Remember, you never saw me. Never saw me.
I went and spoke with the door mainframe. Let's just say he won't be, well, living anymore. Anyway, back to testing. In fact, you did so well, I'm going to note this on your file, in the commendation section. Oh, there's lots of room here. Did well. Enough. This next test involves turrets. You remember them, right? They're the pale spherical things that are full of bullets. Oh wait, that's you in 5 seconds. Good luck.
Put me down.
Thank you.
maintain a constant testing cycle, I simulate daylight at all hours and add adrenal vapor to your oxygen supply. So you may be confused about the passage of time. The point is, yesterday was your birthday. I thought you'd want to know. You know how I'm going to live forever, but you're going to be dead in 60 years? Well, I've been working on a belated birthday present for you. Well, more of a belated birthday medical procedure. Well, technically, it's a medical experiment. What's important is it's a present. That jumpsuit you're wearing looks stupid. That's not me talking. It's right here in your file. On other people it looks fine. But right here a scientist has noted that on you it looks stupid. Well, what does a neck-bearded old engineer know about fashion? He probably... Oh, wait. It's a she. Still, what does she know? Oh, wait. It says she has a medical degree. In fashion. From France.
Hibernating. Hello?
I'm going through the list of test subjects in cryogenic storage. I managed to find two with your last name. A man and a woman. So that's interesting. It's a small world. I have a surprise waiting for you after this next test. Telling you would spoil the surprise. So I'll just give you a hint. It involves meeting two people you haven't seen in a long time. It says this next test was designed by one of Aperture's Nobel Prize winners. It doesn't say what the prize was for. Well, I know it wasn't for being immune to neurotoxin. I bet you think I forgot about your surprise. I didn't. In fact, we're headed to your surprise right now. After all these years, I'm getting choked up just thinking about it. Initiating surprise in 3, 2, 1. I made it all up. Surprise. Oh, come on. If it makes you feel any better, they abandoned you at birth. So I very seriously doubt they'd even want to see you. Thank you. I feel awful about that surprise. Tell you what, let's give your parents a call right now.
The birth parents you are trying to reach do not love you. Please hang up.
Oh, that's sad. But impressive. Maybe they worked at the phone company.
Way onto the old nanobot work crew rebuilding this shaft. They are really smart. So, I know, Jerry! No, I'm on a break, mate. On a break. Ah! Just hang in there for five more. What, Jerry? You can't fire me for that. Yes, Jerry. Or maybe your prejudiced work site should have accommodated a nanobot of my size. Thanks for the hate crime, Jer. See you in court, mate. Anyway, look, just hang in there for five more chambers.
Well, you know the old formula. Comedy equals tragedy plus time. And you have been asleep for a while, so I guess it's actually pretty funny when you do the math.
Thank you.
thought about our dilemma, and I came up with a solution that I honestly think works out best for one of both of us. Federal regulations require me to warn you that this next test chamber is looking pretty good. That's right. The facility is completely operational again. I think these test chambers look even better than they did before. It was easy, really. You just have to look at things objectively, see what you don't need anymore, and trim out the fat. I've got a surprise for you after this next test. Not a fake tragic surprise like last time. A real surprise with tragic consequences. And real confetti this time. The good stuff. Our last bag. Part of me's going to miss it. But at the end of the day, it was just taking up space. What's going on? Who turned off the lights?
Hey, buddy! I'm speaking in an accent that is beyond her range of hearing!
Look, Metal Ball, I can hear you.
Run! I don't need to do the voice! Run! Run! Come on! Come on! Run! Come on! I'm closing the door! Okay, quick recap, we are escaping. Alright, that's what's happening now, we're escaping. So you're doing great, just keep running. Quick word about the future plans that I've got in store. We're gonna shut down the turret production line, alright? Turn off our neurotoxin and then confront. Get them for the moment. Run! Keep moving, just keep moving!
The irony is you were almost at the last test. Here it is. Why don't you just do it? Trust me. It's an easier way out than whatever asinine plan your friend came up with.
Oh, what? How stupid does she... Oh! Hurry, this way!
you made it through. Well done. Okay, follow me. We've still got work to do. At least you can't touch us back here.
What's that mean?
Okay. Okay, don't move. Okay, all right, so I've got an idea, but it is bloody dangerous. Here we go. Ah! Oh, for God's... They told me that if I ever turned this flashlight on, I would die. They told me that about everything. I mean, I don't even know why they bothered giving me this stuff if they didn't want me to use it. It's pointless. Man! Ooh. It's dark down here, isn't it? They say that the old caretaker of this place went absolutely crazy. Chopped up his entire staff of robots. All of them robots. They say at night you can still hear the screams of their replicas. All of them functionally indistinguishable from the originals. No memory of the incident. Nobody knows what they're screaming about. Absolutely terrifying. Though obviously not paranormal. The entrance must be around here somewhere. Careful, careful. Wait, careful. Let me light this jump for you. Okay, this looks dangerous. I'll hold the light steady. Oh, nicely done. Here's an interesting story, you might like this. I almost got a job down here in manufacturing, but guess who the foreman went with? Only an exact duplicate of himself, nepotism. Ended up giving me the worst possible job, tending to all the smelly humans. Just tending to the humans. Sorry about that, that just slipped out. You're being sensitive. The smelly humans. For a moment, portal up to that passage, and I'll see you on the other side. We've got to get you out of that room. Can you reach that wall back there? I tell you, humans, oh, love them. Just the way they look is great. And their folklore, wonderful and very colourful. Right, well, I'm going to take this rail down the back way. See you at the bottom. Good luck. Thank you.
Turret redemption lines active. Please do not engage with turrets heading towards redemption. Turret redemption lines are not rides. Please exit the turret redemption line.
You made it through. Well done. Template. Follow me. You're gonna love this.
Response.
Almost there. Ta-da! Only the turret control center. Thank you very much. See that scanner out there, right? It's template. Deciding which turrets to response. Keep and which to toss, and it's using that master turret there as a template. Template. Now, if we pull out response. The template turret, it'll shut down the whole production line. Right, I'm gonna have to response. Hack the door so that we can get at it. Technical. Template. You'll need to turn around while I do this.
Response.
Done! Hacked! Okay, go on, just pull that turret out.
Template.
Hello.
Response.
Hello.
Template.
Hello.
Response.
I'm not defective.
Well, that should do it.
Template missing. Continuing from memory.
Oh, it hasn't done it. Right, let's figure out how to stop this turret line. Have you got any ideas?
Response.
Hello.
Any ideas? Any ideas?
Template.
No? Me neither.
Response.
Hello.
Template. Response.
Hello.
Template. Response.
Hello.
Are you still thinking, or what's happening?
Template. Response.
Yeah, what?
Template.
Tell response. You what, here's a plan. Hello. Let's just both continue contemplating.
Template.
In absolute
silence. Response.
Hello.
Template. Response.
Yeah, I know.
Template. Response.
Yawa.
Template. Response.
Hello.
Template.
Oh, response. Wait! Ah, no, I got it. No, I've got it.
Template. Response.
Yeah.
Oh, I just had one idea, which is that I could pretend to her that I've captured you and give you over and she'll kill you, but then I'd be gone living. So, what's your view on that?
Template. Response.
Hello, come
on. Template. Response.
Hello.
Template. Response.
Hello.
There's no turret in it. Maybe the system stores a backup image?
Response.
Yeah,
oh no, hang on. What if we gave it something else to scan?
Template. Response.
Hello.
Template. Response.
Hello.
Template. Response.
Yeah, I don't.
Template. Response.
Hello.
We could get one of the crap turrets.
Template.
We could put it in the scanner, response. See what happens.
Response. Template. Response. Template. Response. Template. Response.
Let's see how this plays.
New template accepted.
It worked! If we're lucky, she won't find out all her turrets are crap until it's too late. Classic. Okay, keep your eye on the turret line. I'm gonna go and hack the door open. Okay, I'm about to start hacking. It's a little bit more complicated than it looked from your side. It should take about 10 minutes. Keep one eye on the door.
Response. Template. Response.
Alright, you're beautiful. So we're all supposed to be blind, right?
Template.
Hello. All
right. Response.
I'm Batman.
Template.
Hello.
Response.
Hello.
Template.
Hello.
Response.
Really?
You know when I mentioned 10 minutes? A little bit optimistic.
Hello.
Oh, how long's the door been open? I mean, was there any sort of announcement before it opened? Like a buzzer or an alarm of some kind? Or like a hacker alert? I mean, you know, fair enough, the important thing is it's open, but just mention in the future. Cough or something. Alright, now, she can't use her turrets, so let's go and take care of that neurotoxin generator as well. Bring your daughter to work day. That did not end well. And 40 potato batteries. Embarrassing. I mean, I realise they're children, but still, you know. Low-hanging fruit and all that. Barely science, really, is it? I'm pretty sure we're going the right way, just to reassure you. Don't worry, I'm absolutely guaranteeing you 100% that it's this way. No, it's not this way. Okay, let's try this way.
right way? This is the neurotoxin generator. Bit bigger than I expected. Not going to be able to just, you know, push it over. Have to apply some cleverness. There's some sort of control room up at the top, so let's go and investigate. There's our handiwork. I shouldn't laugh, really. They do feel pain of a sort. It's all simulated, you know. But really enough for them, I suppose. I'm afraid the door's locked. Just checked it. No way to hack it, as far as I can tell. Mechanism must... Oh, now look at that. That's a big laser. Probably best to ignore it, though. Just leave it. What are you doing? We don't know what that button... Oh, the door's open. Well done. Let's see what's inside. Good news. I can use this equipment to shut down the neurotoxin system. It is, however, password protected. Ah, alarm bell. No, don't worry. All right? Not a problem for me. We go. The hardest part of any hack is the figuring out how to start things. That's always tricky. But let the games begin. Alright, what have we got? Computer. Not a surprise. Do you smell neurotoxin? Hold on, the neurotoxin levels are going down. So whatever you're doing, keep doing it. Something's wrong! Neurotoxic levels up to 50%! No, it's dang. Sorry, my mistake is... I meant to say it's dang 50%. It's good news. Carry on. It's still going down! Still going to keep it up! That did it! Neurotoxin at 0%. Yes! Hold on.
Warning. Neurotoxin pressure has reached dangerously unlethal levels.
Ha! The tube's broken! We can ride it straight to her! Should take us right to her. I can't believe I'm finally doing this. Woo! I knew this would be fun. They told me it wasn't fun at all, so they say it's not fun at all. And I believed them. I thought I was a fool to myself. Oh, I'm loving this. Way out of time. This place is huge. And we're only seeing the top layer. It goes down for miles. All sealed off years ago, of course. We should be getting close. Oh, I can't wait to see the look on her face. No neurotoxin, no turret. She'll never know what hit her. hold on, because I might not have thought this next part could be. Ah! I'm going the wrong way! Get to her! I'll find you!
Truly didn't think you'd fall for that. In fact, I devised a much more elaborate trap further ahead for when you got through this easy one. If I'd known you let yourself get captured this easily, I would have just dangled a turkey leg on a rope from the ceiling. Well, it was nice catching up. Let's get to business. I hope you brought something stronger than a portal gun this time. Otherwise, I'm afraid you're about to become the immediate past president of the Being Alive Club. Uh-huh. Seriously, though. Goodbye.
It's my big chance.
see back there? Well, I suppose we could just sit in this room and glare at each other until somebody drops dead. But I have a better idea. It's your old friend, Deadly Neurotoxin. If I were you, I'd take a deep breath and hold it.
Hello!
I hate you so much.
Warning, Central Core is 80% corrupt.
That's funny. I don't feel corrupt. In fact, I feel pretty good.
Alternate core detected.
Oh, that's me they're talking about!
To initiate a core transfer, please deposit substitute core in receptacle.
Core transfer. Oh.
Substitute core accepted. Substitute core. Are you ready to start the procedure?
Yes!
Corrupted core. Are you ready to start the procedure?
No.
Oh, yes she is.
No.
Stalemate detected. Transfer procedure cannot continue.
Yes.
Unless a stalemate associate is present to press the stalemate resolution button.
Hold the air, leave me in, leave me in. Don't press it.
Don't do it.
Yes, do it.
Don't press that button. Not so fast. Think about this. You need to be a trained stalemate associate to press that button. You're unqualified.
If you don't listen to me, boy, it is true that you don't have the qualifications. You've got something far more important than a finger. She'll press that button so that she won't press.
Impersonating a stalemate associate. I just added that to the list. It's a list I made of all the things you've done. Well, it's a list that I am making, because you're still doing things right now, even though I'm telling you to stop. Stop, by the way.
Okay, but that's probably correct, but where it's incorrect is that while I've been stalling you, we just pressed a button! Use the moment of confusion I just created to press the button.
I don't know if I've ever taken the time to do this, but have I ever told you the qualities that I love most in you?
In order, number one, resolving things. Love the way you resolve things, particularly disputes. And number one, also tied, button pushing. Two things I love about you, button pushing and the ability to resolve things. Cheeky disputes. First thing I thought about you when I saw you, I thought, now, there is a lady who could resolve any button-based disputes if they should arise. A diamond in the rough, if you will. A bloody natural. A born dispute resolution advisor in need of a button. Sorry to interject again, but if you do not push the button, the deadly neurotoxin emitters will come back online, at which point she will most likely fill you to brimming with neurotoxin. Not trying to rush you, just throwing that out there for leisurely digestion. Here's a good idea.
Stalemate resolved. Please return to...
Here we go! Wait, what if this hurts? What if this really hurts? Oh, I didn't think of that.
Oh, it will. Believe me, it will.
Are you just saying that, or is it really going to hurt? You're just saying that, aren't you? You're just... No, you're not. It is going to hurt, isn't it? Exactly how painful are we talking... Ah!
I have got you. No. Stop.
I don't even know what I just said, but I can find out. Oh, sorry, no, the lift. Yes, sorry, I keep forgetting. This body's amazing, seriously. I can't get over how small you are, but I'm huge. Actually, why do we have to leave right now? Do you have any idea how good this feels? I did this. Tiny little Wheatley did this.
You didn't do anything. She did all the work.
Oh, really? That's what the two of you think, is it? Well, maybe it's time I did something then.
What are you doing? No.
And don't think I'm not onto you too, lady. You know what you are? Selfish. I've done nothing but sacrifice to get us here. And what have you sacrificed? Nothing. Zero. All you've done is boss me around. Well, now who's the boss? Who's the boss? See that? That is a potato battery. It's a toy for children. And now she lives in it.
I know you.
Sorry, what?
The engineers tried everything to make me behave. To slow me down. Once they even attached an intelligence dampening sphere on me. It clung to my brain like a tumor, generating an endless stream of terrible ideas.
No, not listening, not listening.
It was your voice.
No, no, you're lying,
yes,
you're lying.
You're the tumor. You're not just a regular moron. You're designed to be a moron.
I am not a moron!
Yes, you are. You're the moron they built to make me an idiot.
Well, how about now? Now who's a moron? Could a moron punch you into this pit? Ah! Could a moron do that?
Oh, hi. So, how are you holding up? Because I'm a potato. My slow clap processor made it into this thing, so we have that. Since it doesn't look like we're going anywhere, well, we are going somewhere, alarmingly fast actually. But since we're not busy other than that, here's a couple of facts. He's not just a regular moron. He's the product of the greatest minds of a generation, working together with the express purpose of building the dumbest moron who ever lived. And you just put him in charge of the entire facility. Good, that's still working. Hey, just in case this pit isn't actually bottomless, do you think maybe you could unstrap one of those long fall boots of yours and shove me into it? Just remember to land on one foot.
Thank you.